Divide the rational expressions. Problem number four. In this problem, we are dividing. So, like the other problems before, we will have to factor each individual part, but also use the rule for keep, change the sign to multiplication, and flip to be able to solve this problem. So let's start by factoring this top part. I see they share a common factor of x, and when I take out 1x, I am left with x squared minus 81. Also, when I look at this part, I see that I could continue factoring because this is the difference of two perfect squares. So my x, my GCF, and then factoring the difference of two squares, you write your empty sets of parentheses, square root the first term, which is an x and an x. You need a plus and a minus, and the square root of 81 is 9. And we are done with the first part. Now, the bottom one, I see they have a greatest common factor of x. Taking out an x, I'm left with x minus 5. And that is all for this problem. And now, factoring the top, this is the difference of two perfect squares, like in the previous example. So we could just copy this part, which would be an x plus 9 and an x minus 9, the difference of two squares. And then the bottom one, this is a trinomial with a coefficient of 1. So we use the factoring method of writing our two empty sets of parentheses, square rooting the first term, which is an x and an x, bringing down the first sign, so minus, multiplying the two signs together to give me a plus, because negative times negative is a positive, and then finding the factors of this last number of 10. When you have different signs inside the parentheses, the factors must subtract to give you the middle number, which is 3. You do not need the signs from those numbers because we already did our sign rules. So just deal with the numbers and the factors of 10 that would subtract to give me 3, or 5 times 2, because 5 minus 2 is 3. The larger one always goes first, so my signs match, and I'm done factoring. So now I'm going to deal with this division, and I'm going to keep the first fraction, x minus 9, and then over x and x minus 5. Then I'm changing the sign to multiplication, and I am going to flip the second fraction. So now the denominator is in the numerator, and the numerator goes to the denominator. Now I can cross cancel all the common factors from top and bottom. So I'm going to start here. I have an x on top, x in the bottom, x plus 9 on top, x plus 9 in the bottom, also with x minus 9 on top and in the bottom, x minus 5 on top and in the bottom. So I'm ultimately left, after multiplying what is left, and that is only x plus 2. So my answer is just x plus 2, because everything else canceled out.